Node type converters convert one node type to another node type, which lets you share data across applications. A node type converter lets you copy or transform properties from the source to the target node type. This entity maintenance view has viewpoints for entity dimensions in three applications. All three dimensions use different entity node types. When new entities are added to the general ledger application, they also need to be added to the consolidation and close and planning applications. When I run a comparison between the general ledger and the consolidation and close viewpoints, I get a message that there's not a node type converter defined between the node types. The same happens between the general ledger and the planning viewpoints. Let's add node type converters to the target entity nodes in both target applications. I'll start with financial consolidation and close entities. You create and manage node type converters from the node type inspector for the target node type. Notice that these nodes include a qualifier for the name property. On the Converters tab, click Edit. Add a converter for the source application node type. I'll select Corporate Company from the Financials Cloud application. When you create a node type converter, the source and target properties are auto-mapped for you where possible. In the Operation column, you can select Copy or Transform. I'll copy the core description property to the plan alias default property and save the node type converter. The node type converter now lets you compare the nodes in the first two viewpoints. And in a request, you can drag nodes from the general ledger viewpoint to the consolidation and close viewpoint. Notice that the name, plan alias default, and core description properties were copied from the source to the target. The qualifier defined for the target node type was prefixed to the name property after the node was converted. Now let's add a node type converter to the entity node type for the planning modules application. Notice that this node type also has a qualifier defined. Select the Converters tab and edit to add a node type converter. I'll select Corporate Company from the Financials Cloud application. For planning entities, you want the plan alias default and core description properties to be a combination of the source node's name and description properties. For example, if the source node's name is 100 and the description is North America, you want the planning alias and description to be 100-North America. To do that, you define a transformation expression in the node type converter. Select Transform for the operation, then click Define Expression to open the expression builder. For the expression, start with the source node name, then add a concat method. For the first string value, enter a dash for a separator. And for the second string value, select the core description property for the source node. Apply the expression. I'll add the same expression to the core description property. When you're done, save the node type converter. Returning to the entity maintenance view, you can now compare the general ledger and planning viewpoints. In a request, you can drag nodes from the general ledger viewpoint to the planning viewpoint. Notice that the name property is copied from the source to the target, and the plan alias default and core description properties are concatenated from the source name and description properties. The qualifier defined for the target node type was prefixed to the name property after the node was converted. Enterprise Data Management Cloud supports multiple node type qualifiers for node types. Alternate node type qualifiers let you implement multiple naming schemes for nodes while still letting you locate and compare nodes across viewpoints. You can leverage alternate qualifiers with property transformations on the name property in node type converters, where you can conditionally assign different qualifiers to nodes when they've been shared, mapped, or synchronized across viewpoints. Let's see that in action. The consolidation and close viewpoint includes a legal entity hierarchy that I want to replicate in the planning viewpoint. In planning, I'll give the parent nodes for this hierarchy a prefix of LE underscore, but continue to use C underscore as the prefix for the bottom nodes. Notice that I've already added a top node called legal entities to the planning viewpoint. Start by adding an alternate qualifier to the entity node type for planning. Next, create a node type converter for the planning entity node type, using consolidation and close entity nodes as the source. For the name property, create a conditional transformation expression. For this example, I'll check if the source node has children. Also, because this name transformation should only apply to the legal entity nodes, I'll check if the source node has legal entities as an ancestor. If the conditions are true, then I'll concatenate LE underscore with the source node name, otherwise, I'll concatenate C underscore with the source node name. Save the converter and return to the viewpoint. In a request, when I drag the legal entity parent nodes from the consolidation and close viewpoint to planning, the prefixes are applied correctly by the node type converter. And when I locate the domestic node from consolidation and close in the planning viewpoint, the system uses the alternate node type qualifier to match node names. The default node type qualifier also works to match node names. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.